Hi again, welcome back to SG Dr. Wellness. My name is Dr. Chen Yiming. Last week, I've talked about urinary tract infection in females. Click on the link on the top right now to assess it. And as promised, this week, we'll be talking about urinary tract infection in men. Urinary tract infection in men is also caused by organisms such as bacteria. What are the risk factors for men getting it? What are the symptoms? What's the difference between UTI in men and UTI in women? Should you see a doctor if you have symptoms of male UTI? Watch till the end to know more about it. And if you're new to our channel, click on the subscribe button now. Now, the urinary system in men is very much the same as the female except for two differences. The upper urinary system is made up of the kidneys and ureters, and the lower urinary system is made up of the bladder, prostate, and urethra. The two biggest differences of the male urinary system from the females are, in males, we have this walnut-sized organ called the prostate just below the bladder, and the urethra that brings the urine from the bladder out of the body is much longer in the male due to the presence of the penis. Like I shared with you in the other video on female UTI, it's very common for ladies to have urinary tract infection, and it's usually not very worrying. On the other hand, however, it is uncommon for young men to have UTI, simply because the urethra is longer, and that by itself is a form of natural protection against bacteria climbing up the urinary system. In fact, it's estimated that women are at a 30 times higher risk of getting UTI than men. Therefore, whenever I see a male patient with first onset UTI in my practice, I almost always refer the patient to the urologist for further investigation and scans to find out the underlying cause. Some of the causes of male urinary tract infection includes prostate enlargement, either by benign prostate hyperplasia or prostate cancer, urethra tightening, that could be due to previous surgeries or scopes or infections, recent instrumentation, meaning medical instruments has been inserted into the urinary tract, such as urine catheter or scope. 4. Urinary stones. 5. Sexually transmitted infections such as chlamydia or gonorrhea. 6. Poor immune system due to diabetes or HIV. As a guide, the top cause of urinary tract infection in men above 50 is benign prostate hyperplasia, whereas the top cause of urinary tract infection in men below 50 is usually sexually transmitted disease. Men with lower urinary tract infection may present with symptoms of burning sensation during urination, increased urgency to urinate, frequent sensation of needing to pass urine, cloudy, smelly urine, blood in urine, pain in the lower abdominal area, penile discharge. And if this infection spread upwards to the urinary system, it can lead to an upper urinary tract infection. The patient can have additional symptoms of fevers and chills, pain in the upper back and sides, nausea and vomiting, and extreme feeling of unwell. Male urinary tract infection must be properly investigated and treated. In addition, the underlying cause of the infection must be sought out. Some of the initial physical examinations and investigations I would do in my clinic includes a digital prostate examination. So based on the feel and the size of the prostate, we can make an educated guess if this patient has prostate infection or if the prostate is enlarged. In certain situations, we may even be able to detect a prostate cancer. Secondly, urine dipsticks. These are very convenient tests that can be done in the clinic with results obtained between 5 to 10 minutes. This allows me to confirm the diagnosis of urinary tract infection on the spot. Number 3, urine form element microscopic examination, or UFIM for short, and urine cultures. These tests are done and sent to the laboratory for visual confirmation of the urine infection and for identification of the bacteria that is causing the infection. Fourthly, urine PCR, or urine polymerase chain reaction, to detect sexually transmitted bacteria like chlamydia and gonorrhea. These bacteria cannot be grown on urine cultures, and a PCR test is needed to identify them. Following which, I would definitely start the patient on the appropriate antibiotics before I refer them to urologists for further investigations. As you have learned, urinary tract infection in men are uncommon and are complicated. If you are a guy and you do have symptoms of UTI, please see your doctor as soon as possible to have it investigated and treated. Otherwise, complications may likely happen. So thank you for watching till the end. Subscribe, like, and share this video if you find it beneficial. Till the next time, stay safe and stay healthy.